Submarines are one of the most important and destructive weapons a military can have. They are stealthy, they can remain underwater for months, and they can carry nuclear missiles. However, one question arises. How do you communicate with a submerged submarine? In this video, I'll explain it. Spoiler! There is some crazy engineering going on. One way is to use a 135-kilometer antenna that emits radio waves at a wavelength of 3000 kilometers. I'll talk about that later in the video. The difficulty of communication with submarines is that radio waves don't travel well through salt water, as it's a good electrical conductor. For example, high and ultra-high frequencies, which ships use for communication, can't penetrate more than a meter into salt water. The only way for a submarine to communicate on such frequencies is by rising at periscope depth and deploying an antenna above water. That's of course not what you really wanna do as a submarine, as it will reveal your position to enemies, which is no bueno. For this reason, Navy uses very low frequency radio waves, or VLF, for communication with submarines. These frequencies range from 3 to 30 kHz and can penetrate 30 to 40 meters into the ocean. However, VLF has some serious disadvantages. First of all, since the wavelengths at these frequencies range from 10 to 100 kilometers, you need really huge and powerful antennas to transmit VLF. Like, we're talking about antennas covering several square kilometers. As you can imagine, it's physically impossible to fit such an antenna on a submarine. For this reason, VLF communication is only one way from land to submarine. Submarines can only receive such frequencies, either by trailing along cable or by deploying a buoy equipped with an antenna, which is attached to a submarine by a cable. Another problem with VLF is that it has very low bandwidth. You can only communicate via Morse code, which then gets translated into text, while higher frequencies, for example, can support even voice communication. However, it's possible to communicate on even lower frequencies, called extremely low frequencies, or ELF, which ranges from 3 to 300 Hz. Okay, this is the craziest part. Amidst the Cold War, the US Navy proposed building an antenna in Wisconsin that will cover 58,000 square kilometers, which is 2/5 of the entire state. It will consist of 9,700 kilometers of buried cables in a rectangular grid, which will cover 58 square kilometers. The antenna will have been powered by 100 underground power plants, allowing it to survive even a nuclear attack. The reason they wanted to build it is that the radio waves at such frequencies can penetrate hundreds of meters into the ocean, which is huge. As you can imagine, they didn't actually build it, as it was simply too expensive and too complicated. There was some strong opposition from environmental and anti-war groups. But they did manage to build a scaled-down version of the system in 1982. That system was called Project TLF, and it consisted of two transmitter facilities, one in Wisconsin and one in Michigan. The way it worked was that both sites had kilometers of overhead cables, resembling ordinary power lines, and the cables were grounded at the ends. The signal transmitted through the cables traveled through buried electrodes deep into the ground, and then that signal could travel thousands of kilometers, which allowed communication, I guess, with almost every submarine that the US had. Sadly, Project TLF was shut down in 2004, so it's not operational today. However, China has recently built its own ELF antenna, the size of New York City, and I think India has recently upgraded its VLF antenna to transmit ELF radio waves. So I believe these two countries are currently operating such antennas. Also, the USSR had such an antenna near Murmansk, but I don't know if it still works or not. Either way, the bandwidth of ELF is extremely low. It takes 15 minutes to transmit a three-letter code, so the system is mainly used to sort of pin a submarine to get it to rise, and then communication is done either through VLF or high frequencies. But it's still cool that we can communicate with a submarine this deep, even if communication is very limited. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, you can watch my other videos too. See you soon. Bye!